and welcome to this virtual service from St. Martin's Church, Delhi Cantonment. Today is the 20th Sunday after Pentecost, and the theme for our meditation this morning is the spiritual danger of trusting in wealth. Let not the flesh rich man glory in his riches, but let him who glories glory in this, that he understands and knows me, that I am the Lord, who practice steadfast love, justice and righteousness in the earth. Let us praise God by singing the opening hymn.
Time.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. May we all pray together. The collect that will appear on your screens, please pray along with me. Grant us, Lord, not to be anxious about earthly things, but to love things heavenly. And while we dwell among things that are passing away, so to use them that we may attain to those that endure, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and ever. Amen. We shall now hear ministry of the word.
Today's Old Testament reading has been taken from Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 6 to 18. Moses warns the people not to forget God when they become rich and prosperous in the land of Palestine. You shall keep the commandments of the Lord your God by walking in his ways and by fearing him. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land of brooks of water, of fountains and springs, flowing forth in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land in which you will eat bread without scarcity, in which you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron, and out of whose hills you can dig copper. And you shall eat and be full, and you shall bless the Lord your God for the good land he has given you. Take heed lest you forget the Lord your God, by not keeping his commandments and his ordinances and his statutes, which I command you this day, lest, when you have eaten and are full, and have built goodly homes and live in them, and when your herds and flocks multiply, and your silver and gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied, then your heart be lifted up, and you forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness, with its fiery serpents and scorpions, and thirsty ground where there was no water, who brought you water out of the flinty rock, who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you and test you, to do you good in the end. Beware lest you say in your heart, my power and the might of my hand have gotten me this wealth. You shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, that he may confirm his covenant which he swore to your fathers. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God.
Today's responsive reading has been taken from Psalm chapter 49, verses 1 and 2, and 16 to 19. Your response shall be, if riches increase, set not your heart upon them. O hear ye this, all ye people, ponder it with your ears, and all ye that dwell in the world. High and low, rich and poor, yea, every man with his neighbor. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. Be not envious if a man be made rich, or if the glory of his house be increased. For he shall carry nothing away with him when he die, neither shall his pomp follow him. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. For though while he lived, he counted himself an happy man, and while he did well unto himself, men spake good of him. He shall follow the generation of his fathers, who shall never see the light. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. This is the word of God.
का वचन लिया गया है प्रकाशित वाक्य 3:14-22 तक, रेवलेशन 3:14-22। लौदीकिया की कलीसिया के दूत को यह लिख, जो आमीन और विश्वास योग्य के साथ सच्चा गवाह है और परमेश्वर की सृष्टि का मूल कारण है, वो ये कहता है कि मैं तेरे कामों को जानता हूं कि तू ना तो ठंडा है और ना गर्म। भला होता कि तू ठंडा या गर्म होता, इसलिए कि तू गुनगुना है और ना ठंडा है और ना गर्म, मैं तुझे अपने मुंह में से उगलने पर हूं। तू कहता है कि मैं धनी हूं और धनवान हो गया हूं और मुझे किसी वस्तु की घटी नहीं, और ये नहीं जानता कि तू अभागा और तुच्छ और कंगाल और अंधा और नंगा है। इसीलिए मैं तुझे सम्मति देता हूं कि आग में ताया हुआ सोना मुझसे मोल ले कि तू धनी हो जाए, और श्वेत वस्त्र ले ले और पहनकर अपने नंगेपन की लज्जा ना हो, और अपने आंखों में लगाने के लिए सुरमा ले ले कि तू देखने लगे। मैं जिन जिन से प्रेम करता हूं उन सब को उलाहना और ताड़ना देता हूं, इसलिए सरगर्म और मन फिरा। देख, मैं द्वार पर खड़ा हुआ खटखटाता हूं, और यदि कोई शब्द सुनकर मेरा द्वार खोलेगा तो मैं उसके पास भीतर आकर उसके साथ भोजन करूंगा और वो मेरे साथ, और जब जो जय पाए मैं उसे अपने साथ अपने सिंहासन पर बैठाऊंगा, जैसे मैं भी जय पाकर अपने पिता के साथ उसके सिंहासन पर बैठ गया। जिसके कान हो वो सुन ले कि आत्मा कलीसियाओं से क्या कहता है। परमेश्वर इसके वचन के पढ़े और सुने जाने पर अपनी आशीष दे, आमीन।
बिफोर वी हियर द होली गॉस्पल, मे वी प्रेज गॉड बाय सिंगिंग आवर ग्रेजुअल हिम्न।
Thank you.
The rich man who desired to become a disciple found himself unable to respond to the call of Jesus because he could not give up his wealth. The Holy Gospel is found recorded in the 10th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Mark, verses 17 to 27. Your response, glory to you, Christ Jesus. As he was sitting out on his journey, a man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" And Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments: do not kill, do not commit adultery, do not steal, do not bear false witness, do not defraud, honor your father and mother." And he said to him, "Teacher, all these I have observed from my youth." And Jesus, looking up to him, loved him and said to him, "You lack one thing. Go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven. And come and follow me." At that saying, his countenance fell, and he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. And Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it will be for those who have riches to enter the kingdom of God." And the disciples were amazed at his words. But Jesus said to him again, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God." And they were exceedingly astonished and said to him, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "With men it is impossible, but not with God, for all things are possible with God." Amen. This is the Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Friends, I'm happy to announce the names of those who would be celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries during the coming week from our St. Martin's Church family. We have Monica Sampson, Abhishek Mins, James Paul, Sanjay Massey, Alma Tamanna, Santosh Kumar, Alpha Mins, Paul Alfred David, Surit Sondhi, Sharon Bernard, Angel A. Thomas, who would be celebrating their birthdays. We have Nita and Sushil Falls, Ruby and Sandeep Srivastava, Seema and Ajay Kachap, Salom and Edwin Thomas, who will be celebrating their wedding anniversaries. May we offer a prayer for all of them. Let us pray. Gracious, loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you, for these are members whose names we have pronounced here in your presence this morning. We pray that your abundant blessings be upon those who are celebrating their birthdays and those celebrating their wedding anniversaries. Bless these individuals, the couples, that they may be blessed by you and in turn become a blessing for others. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you continue to bless them, their families, their profession, that, Heavenly Father, all that they do and say may be according to your will, that would please them and qualify them to receive your blessings, and in return become a blessing for others. In Jesus' mighty, sweet, and holy name we pray. Amen.
Good morning to everyone. Praise the Lord. And God bless you. As per the reading today, we see that a young man came to Jesus, but he found himself unworthy to become his disciple. The theme says the spiritual danger of trusting in wealth. Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and redeemer. Amen. As you see that the gospel has been taken from gospel according to Saint Mark, chapter 10, verses 17 to 27. It gives a wonderful story of a young man who came to Jesus seeking eternal life. It is a plight of each one of us. We are no different than this young man. I'll tell you my own story. Forget about others, forget about anyone else, but you should hear to my own story. I was a young priest in the diocese of Amritsar, and my residence in the diocese was in a school. From there, I used to commute to the diocese office and to the church. To add, or to top of it, my administrator also used to stay just opposite to my room in the school. You can imagine when your administrator is staying and you are a young person who has joined very recently. But he was a very nice man. He is a very nice man. He's still alive and has been a mentor to me for a very, very long time. And one day we were going to the office and the winter was setting in. I saw a man with few clothes on his body. While being in the diocese of Amritsar, I was 1,500 kilometers away from my home. And I used to earn in the diocese, and you know, as a priest, we always depend on the mercies of God. While going to my office with my administrator, I saw this man and I told him that if I had a little more money, I would have bought a winter jacket for him and given it to him. My administrator, he looked at me and he said, "How many jackets do you have?" I said, "I have only 2 jackets. Why don't you give one to him?" And I looked at him. I said, "Sir, what will I wear once I wash my jacket?" He said, "My friend, God will provide and you can still have another jacket." But I never gave my jacket to that person and I never bought a second jacket at that point of time. In the same way, this man comes to Jesus. When he comes to Jesus, you see, he just does not walk towards him, but he runs towards him and fell on his knees and he says, "Good teacher." That means this person was following Christ. That means this person was observing him. That means this person wanted something from Christ. It is a very polite way of saying to a teacher, "Good teacher." That means the teacher knows his subject well. That means the teacher knows his disciples well. And the next question comes to him, "What must I do to inherit eternal life. Well, Jesus looks at him and he says that only God is perfect and God is good. Amen. Only God is an exceptional. Only God is perfect. And that is why he says that, why do you call me good? But anyway, Jesus continues and he says, have you followed the commandments? Have you followed the law? The law is very, very vast in the Jewish society. For each and every action, there is something or the other to be kept in mind. And this person says, yes, I have followed law since I was a boy. That means the person was a learned person. That means he was a rich person. It is only the rich who were able to afford a good schooling, a good knowledge about their own country law. It is important to know that this man who came to Jesus was not an ordinary citizen, but he was a man of honor and wealth, a man who had not only wealth but also had morality, a man who not only had morality but he was a young and had morality. He was a man of good rank. He was a man who was filled with enthusiasm. He was a man who came at the right time, at the right place, to the right entity. That is Christ. And when he comes to him, Jesus ask him that, have you kept the law? And he says, yes, I have kept the law. And verse 21 says, Jesus looked at him and loved him. Jesus looked at him and loved him. Then he says to him, if you remember, I told you that he addresses Jesus as good teacher. So good teacher also knows his disciples and also loves his disciples. And then he says to him, one thing you lack. That means the disciple was near to perfect. The disciple was close to be the best disciple of Christ. And he says to him, go sell everything and give it to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. I believe hearing these words from the mouth of Christ, he must have almost thought that Jesus asked for his soul. The very next sentence which comes is, at this man's face fell. He went away sad, because he had great wealth. the Savior offered him. The Savior offered him to come and follow him. The Savior offered him to be his best friend. The Savior offered him to love him more. The Savior offered him the cross. The Savior offered him a place to dwell with him. But this man, this young man, he couldn't part from his wealth. How many times in our lives do we love something more than God? How many times in our lives do we love things more than our neighbor? So much so that we are not ready to part from it. So much so that we are not ready to give it for the sake of others. So much so that we are not ready to sell it and distribute the proceeds from it to the ones who need it the most. And when this man goes away, what does Christ say? Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it is for rich to enter the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God." He goes on further to say that it is easy for a camel to pass from the eye of the needle. You and I, we know it is absolutely impossible for a camel to pass from the eye of a needle. But this imagery is used for us. This imagery of passing a camel from the eye of a needle is compared with us. Can we pass through the eye of a needle? Can we pass, can we move forward from attaching ourselves to the pleasures of the world? Can we move further from the wealth that we possess and trusting in a wealth that it can gain for us or bring us anything and everything that we desire? When the young man went away from Christ, he went away from the presence of God. He forfeited his eternal life. He walked away in sorrow. And I wonder, throughout his life, he must have lived in sorrow. Throughout his life, this question would have bothered him. Even after my death, will I get eternal life? What a tragedy. He came so close to the kingdom of God, that one step would have brought him inside the gates of heaven. But one step which he takes back moved him away forever from the kingdom of heaven. In the gospel, Christ in verse 24 says, "But Jesus said again, 'Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. Do you know the most important thing about children? They just live by the means. Whatever is provided to them keeps them happy. Whatever is given to them makes them happy. They don't lust, they don't greed, but they are happy in their own surrounding. That is why it is easier for the children to enter the kingdom of heaven, because their trust is in their parents. In the same way, where does our trust lie? Does it lie in the wealth which we have accumulated? Does it lie in what our spirit is attached to? Or does it lie to where our spirit should be? Let us look to God in prayer, asking Him to bless us, to be out of such tragedy of moving away from the kingdom of God. Let us pray. Lord, our Heavenly Father, we once again come into your presence. We thank you, Lord, for giving us this example of this young man moved away from your presence, O Lord. Help us, O Lord, to learn from the example of others, so that we may always be found rejoicing in your presence. We ask this prayer in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us reaffirm our faith together in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
In our intercession, let us join our prayer for the whole human family with the unceasing prayer of Christ the Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray for justice and peace in the world and fullness of life to everyone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all who live in this place, for Delhi and NCR, for the removal of all that divides us from each other, and for true harmony in our country. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all engaged in agriculture, industry, and commerce, for all workers, skilled and unskilled, and for all those who defend our country, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For teachers and students, scientists, artists, and writers, and for all who influence the minds and hearts of others, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those who are suffering, the poor and hungry, the destitute and oppressed, the unemployed, the sick and dying, and for all who help them, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all to whom authority is entrusted in this and other countries, and especially for our President, the Prime Minister, the Lieutenant Governor, and Chief Minister of Delhi, and for all who have power over other people, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the unity of all Christian people and for their witness and service in the world, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For your whole church in our country, for its councils and leaders, especially for P.C. Singh, our bishop and moderator, A. Dharmaraj Rasalam, moderator of the Church of South India, Mar Theodosius, metropolitan of the Mathama Church, for Sunil Gazan and Samuel Shaker, our presbyters, and for all other ministers of your church, that they may be faithful in their ministry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. That with all your people who have faithfully served you in this life, we also may share in the eternal joy of your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hasten, Heavenly Father, the coming of your kingdom, and grant these petitions which we offer in the name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Confession of Sin. Beloved, our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us therefore confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved by God's grace to keep his commandments and to live in love and peace with all people. Let us say together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against one another, in thought and word and deed, in the evil we have done and in the good we have not done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who forgive one another, and truly repent of their sins, have mercy on us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thanks be to God. Beloved in Christ, this is the time to share the peace of God. Let us remember that our Lord Jesus Christ came into this world to forgive sinners and to die for them and to shed his precious blood. He also taught us to qualify before we ask our forgiveness by teaching us to pray, Father, forgive us our sins, for we also have forgiven those who have sinned against us. He said, if you are about to offer your gift at the altar, and there you remember that you have something against your brother, leave your gift at the altar. First, go and be reconciled, and then come and offer your gift at the altar. As we share this peace of God with one another, let us remember that we are the body of Christ. In the one spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share this peace with one another. As we sing this hymn, or share the peace, let us sing our offertory hymn. The facilities, how you could contribute towards our ministry, will appear on your screens. And this is in response to the people who keep asking us how they could contribute. So the facility will appear on your screen, UPI. Please use it if you wish. Let us sing our offertory hymn. Thank you. Let us present these offerings and with them ourselves for the service of the Divine Majesty. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Almighty God, Creator of the world, we ask you to accept these offerings for the glory of your name and the good of your people, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, so we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Let us receive God's blessings. And now, unto God's gracious mercy and protection, we commit you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest and remain with each one of you and with all your dear ones, wherever they may be, in each and every home who has worshipped with us virtually, and every home that regularly participates in this worship service now and forevermore. Amen. Beloved in Christ, I like to extend our heartfelt gratitude for those who work behind the production of this worship service that you regularly participate in or watch. We are indeed grateful to Mr. Alvin Theodore, Mr. John Manohar, Nitin, and this time Reverend Shekhar Sambal, who has been helpful in recording this worship service. We are getting a lot of good feedback from people, and we wish to continually serve you by offering this worship service that we prepare. May God continue to bless all of us, and till then may we continue to pray for the eradication of this COVID virus, especially the second wave that we are all fearing. May we praise God by singing our closing hymn.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon, it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Precious blood. Oh, that day when freed from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransomed soul away. Send thine angels now to carry me to realms of endless day. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor daily I am constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.